Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon, Mr. Johannes Selatan, and good afternoon, everyone. Allow me to introduce ourselves. We are from Group 7. I'm Almu Diawati from Haji Hospital as the moderator. And then there is Cassandra Putri Sutesa Intan from Japan, Delia Octaviani from Anissa Hospital, Denny Chandra from Kanagawa, Japan, Rafiq from Pusat Angkatan Darat Hospital, Rora Luciana from Okayama, Japan, and then Yudhistira from Anissa Hospital. Today we are going to give a presentation about hospitalizing and simple future plans. Now, please allow us to start the presentation. For Ms. Rora, you may start. Ms. Rora, are you ready?
Hi. So now I will explain about word part of speech. For the first noun, sis is noun. The meaning is a sac in the body tissue filled with fluid. Sometimes deceased. Artinya kantong pada jaringan tubuh yang berisi cairan dan gas. Next is deaf, word adjective. The meaning is unable to hear atau tidak dapat mendengar. Deficiency is noun, is a lack of something necessary for one's health, or kurangnya suatu hal yang penting untuk kesehatan tubuh seseorang. Dehydrate or adjective is in need of water, or kebutuhan air. And the next is dementia is noun. The meaning is loss of mental capacity, yang artinya kehilangan kemampuan mental. Next is diabetes is noun. Diabetes is a type of disease typically involving insulin deficiency, yang artinya penyakit yang disertai kekurangan insulin. Next is diagnosis is noun. Medical explanation of an illness or condition, yaitu penjelasan medis mengenai suatu penyakit atau kondisi. Next is disease is noun. The meaning is a medical disorder that is harmful to a person's health. Kelainan medis yang berbahaya bagi kesehatan seseorang. And the last one is dislocate is adjective. That the meaning is when a bone is temporarily separate from its joint. Itu ketika tulang terpisah sementara dari tulang sendinya. And the next is emergency. It's a medical problem that needs immediate attention. Itu masalah medis yang membutuhkan perhatian segera. The next is ER, emergency room is noun. The hospital room used for treating patients with immediate and life threatening injuries. Artinya ruangan di rumah sakit yang digunakan untuk perawat pasien dengan luka yang serius dan mengancam hidup. Next is external is adjective. The meaning is on the outside atau di luar. Then family history. Family history is a noun. The meaning is medical background of a person's family members. Latar belakang medis anggota keluarga pasien. Fatal, it's adjective, causing death, menyebabkan kematian. Fever is noun and fever is adjective. Higher than normal body temperature, yang artinya lebih tinggi dari suhu tubuh normal. Flu or influenza, it's noun. Many types of respiratory or intestinal infections passed on through virus, beberapa jenis infeksi pernapasan dan usus yang melewati virus. And the next is fracture, is noun, and fractured is adjective. Broken or cracked bone, tulang yang patah dan retak. And the last one is germ, is a noun, is a microorganism, especially one that causes disease. Is microorganisme khususnya sesuatu yang menyebabkan penyakit.
Victoria, you can read the slide number 5, please.
The next is genetic or noun is a medical condition or physical feature that is passed on in the family. Kondisi medis atau fisik dalam keluarga. Growth is tissue that grows bigger than normal either on or under the skin. Jaringan yang berkembang lebih besar dari ukuran normal baik di dalam maupun di bawah kulit. And then heart attack, it's a noun. Blood stops pumping through the heart. Darah berhenti memompa melalui jantung. HIV is the virus that infects the human T cells and leads to AIDS. Virus yang menginfeksi sel T pada tubuh manusia dan menyebabkan AIDS. And then hive is noun. Bumps that appear on the surface of the skin during an allergic reaction. Is benjolan yang muncul di permukaan kulit selama reaksi alergi. And next is illness. It's a noun and ill, it's adjective. General term for any condition that makes a person feel sick for a certain period of time. Nah, artinya istilah umum untuk kondisi yang membuat seseorang sakit dalam jangka waktu tertentu. And immune system is a noun, the parts of the body that fight disease, infections, and virus. Bagian tubuh yang melawan penyakit, infeksi, dan virus. And the last one, immunization is a noun and immunize is verb. Is an injection, that protects against a specific disease. Nah, artinya suntikan yang melawan penyakit tertentu. Next is incision is a noun. Cut in the body made during surgery. Yang artinya luka pada tubuh akibat operasi. Inconclusive is adjective. The meaning is unclear or tidak jelas. Infant is a noun. Or young baby, atau bayi. The next is infections, is noun, infected, is adjective. Diseased area of the body, or viral, or bacterial, area berpenyakit pada tubuh. Inflamed, is adjective. The meaning is appearance, or red and swollen, of an injured body part. Merah dan bengkak dari bagian tubuh yang terluka. And the next is injury is a noun. The meaning is damage to the body or kerusakan pada tubuh. Intensive care unit or ICU is a noun. The meaning is sections of the hospital where patients get constant attention and doctors rely on specialized equipment. Ruangan di rumah sakit tempat pasien mendapatkan perhatian dan perawatan dokter yang dilengkapi peralatan khusus. And the last one is internal is adjective. The meaning is under the skin inside the organs. Yang artinya di bawah kulit di dalam organ.
Adjective. Feeling discomfort on the skin surface atau perasaan tidak nyaman pada permukaan kulit. Lab result, a noun, test that come back from a laboratory and help doctor make a diagnosis. Test hasil laboratorium dan bersifat membantu dokter dalam mendiagnosa. Lab laboratory, a noun, place where a sample of blood or urine are are taken for testing. Tempat di mana sampel darah atau rutin dan lain-lain diambil untuk pengetesan. Life support non a machine that keeps patient alive by helping them breathe. Mesin yang memonitor pasien untuk tetap hidup dengan membantu pasien tersebut untuk bernafas. Life threatening adjective when injuries and condition are extremely serious. Ketika luka dan kondisi sangat serius. Like headed adjective feeling of dizziness and being off balance caused by lack of oxygen in the brain. Perasaan pusing dan tidak seimbang disebabkan oleh kurangnya oksigen di otak. Medical school, mid school, non place where someone trains to be a doctor. Tempat di mana seseorang dididik menjadi seorang dokter. Newborn, non, an infant that is less than 3 months old. Bayi yang berumur kurang dari 3 bulan. Adjective, no feeling in certain body part. Mati rasa pada bagian tubuh tertentu. Our operating room, non, the place where major surgeries and operation take place. Tempat di mana pembedahan dan operasi besar berlangsung. Paralyzed, adjective, unable to move certain area of the body. Tidak mampu untuk membedakan area tubuh tertentu. Patient, non, person staying in a hospital or medical facility. Seseorang yang dirawat di rumah sakit atau fasilitas medis. Pharmacist, non, person who files doctor's prescription and gives people advice about medication. Seseorang yang mengisi resep dokter dan memberikan nasihat mengenai pengobatan seseorang. Farmasi, drugstore, non, place where people go to buy medication and other medical supplies. Tempat di mana orang-orang membeli obat dan persediaan medis lainnya. Physician, non, doctor. Potion, non, potioners, adjective. A substance that is very dangerous if it enters the human body. Zat yang sangat berbahaya jika masuk ke dalam tubuh manusia. Prescription, non, prescribed verb. The correct amount and type of medication needed to cure an illness or relief symptoms. Jumlah dan tipe pengobatan yang tepat dibutuhkan untuk menyembuhkan penyakit atau meringankan gejala. Radiation, non, high energy X-ray that destroy cancer cell. Energi sinar elektromagnetik tinggi yang menghancurkan sel kanker. Residency, non, resident, non, part of a doctor's training that takes place in the hospital. A student working under a doctor, bagian dari pendidikan dokter yang berlangsung di rumah sakit. Mahasiswa kedokteran yang bekerja di bawah dokter. Scrubs, non, plain uniform, usually green, white or blue, worn by medical professional. Seragam polos, biasanya hijau, putih atau biru, yang dikenakan ahli medis. Scrubs up for carefully wash and before and after seeing a patient. Cuci tangan sebelum dan sesudah menemui pasien. Second opinion, non, input from a second doctor about an illness or symptom. masukan dari dokter lain mengenai suatu penyakit atau gejala. Seizure, non, sudden, violent movement, or unconsciousness caused by electrical signal malfunction in the brain. Pergerakan hebat secara tiba-tiba atau ketidaksadaran yang disebabkan oleh malfungsi sinyal listrik pada otak. Shock, non, body not getting enough blood flow. Tubuh tidak mendapatkan cukup aliran darah. Side effect, non, other symptoms that might occur as a result of a certain medication or procedure. Gejala lain yang mungkin muncul sebagai hasil dari pengobatan atau prosedur tertentu.
Thank you, Mr. Yudhistira. Next slide, Mr. Denny, are you ready? Slide number 10 and 11.
Yes, thank you. Aspirin, known the controllable tightening of muscle. Specialist known a doctor that is an expert in a certain kind of medicine. Sprain, known or verb, an injury less serious than a break to a joint, ankle, knee. Stable condition, pronoun, a patient is stable if their medical condition is not longer changing rapidly. Sting, noun or verb, sharp temporary pain. Stress, noun, worry that cause muscles to tighten and blood pressure to rise. Stressed, adjective, the resort pronoun, medical information that help doctor and understand a patient condition or body. Therapy pronoun, the meaning treatment aimed at improving a patient mental or physical condition. Transplant pronoun, the meaning moving of an organ from one human to another. Okay, next. Ultrasound pronoun, a test that examines the body internal organ and process using sound waves often used during pregnancy. Unconscious adjective, alive but appearing to be asleep and unaware of the surroundings. Pain pronoun, the meaning the thing to transport blood around the body and back to the heart. Virus pronoun, the meaning a dangerous organism that caused the spread of minor and major disease. Visiting house pronoun, times of day when friend and family and elevate to visit patient in hospital. Ward pronoun, the meaning a section of a hospital of health facility where patients stay. Well care pronoun, the meaning a care on well used for transporting patient for place to place. X-ray pronoun of birth, the meaning a photograph of a person bone and organs.
Okay, thank you. Next, the epiglottitis. The epiglottis is a flexible flap at the superior end of the larynx in the throat. It acts as a switch between the larynx and the esophagus to permit air to enter the airway to the lung and food to pass into the gastrointestinal tract. The epiglottis also protects the body from choking on food that would normally obstruct the airway. The epiglottis is a thin, lip-shaped structure at the superior border of the larynx or voice box. In its relaxing position, the epiglottis projects into the pharynx or throat and rests just posterior to the tongue. The epiglottis is made of elastic cartilage covered with mucous membrane. Is its anterior surface consists of non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium that is consistent with the tissue of the mouth and the pharynx. On the posterior surface, it is covered with pseudosterifice columnar epithelium that is consistent with the tissue lining the larynx. Under the epithelial layer is a thin layer of areolar connective tissue that provide a loose attachment for the epithelium and supplies it with blood vessels and nerve fibers. Throughout each day, the epiglottis spend the vast majority of its time relaxed at the superior edge of the larynx, just posterior to the tongue. In the position, air is able to enter the pharynx from the nose or mouth and pass freely into the larynx and onward to the lung. It is only when we swallow food or drink that the epiglottis move and perform its vital function. The process of swallowing is a complex process involving many structures in the head and neck. During the process, the pharynx heard and larynx and pulled separately to allow the pharynx to widen and receive the material being swallowed. Next. Epiglottis vocabulary. Epiglottis adalah katup tenggorokan, fleksibel, lunak atau mudah dilenturkan, flap, penutup atau tutup, laring, pangkal tenggorokan, throat atau tenggorokan, esophagus, saluran makanan atas atau tenggorokan, obstruct, menghalangi, pharynx, tekak atau hulu tenggorokan, cartilage, tulang rawan, vessels, pembuluh. Next. Simple future tense is a tense to describe an event that has not started and will occur in the future. Sentence in the simple future tense can be marked with the use of the word will, shall, and going to. Simple future tense is also used to express a prediction or wish. Broadly speaking, the word will, shall, and going to have the same meaning, which means will. However, in some circumstances, the word can also have different meaning based on the context. Next.
Okay, Mr. Benny, are you ready? Mr. Benny, are you ready to read the slide number 17?
Okay, I'm sorry. Next, will is you said for the word I, you, we, they, see, and it. So is you said for the word I and we. You said to express desire or not. You said that a general fact or truth. Make a promise of or over UNICEF's spontaneously. Going to can be used for the word I, you, we, they, she, and it. Used to be am, is, are after the subject. Example, I am going to, she is going to. You see the express a wish, but it's just an intention. Next, formula. Will, shall, positive sentence, subjects plus will, shall plus verb one. Example, I will be a teacher. He will take school examination next month. Negative sentence. Subject plus will, shall plus not plus verb one. Example, we shall not stay here. He will not join our sport club. Interrogative sentence. Will, shall plus subject plus verb one. Example, shall we go to Lombok next week? Will you come with me to the party tonight? Next, going to number one, positive sentence, subject plus to be plus going to plus verb one. Example, I am going to paint my bedroom tomorrow. Dini is going to finish her homework tonight. Negative sentence, subject plus to be plus not plus going to plus verb one. Example, she is not going to read the book tomorrow. Interrogative sentence, to be plus subject plus going to plus verb one. Example, are you going to the beach next week? Okay. Next, adverb of time. Tomorrow, artinya besok, later, artinya nanti, next week, minggu depan, next month, bulan depan, next year, tahun depan, soon, segera, tonight, malam ini, by and by, sebentar lagi, the day after tomorrow, artinya lusa.